Does eating breakfast really matter as a basketball player? Today we're going to discuss three things you need to consider when deciding whether or not breakfast really needs to fit into your nutrition plan. And at the end of the video, I'm going to share with you one of my favorite unconventional breakfast tips that's going to make this process a whole lot easier for you. When it comes to breakfast, there's always this debate whether or not it really matters, whether it's this social construct that's perpetuated by cereal companies to get you to buy their stuff, or if it actually is the most important meal of the day. And honestly, for a lot of hoopers, it can be difficult at first to get breakfast in consistently. So the idea of being able to skip breakfast and intermittent fast or whatever is kind of appealing in that sense. But there are three things we need to consider when looking at whether or not breakfast needs to fit into your plan. And at the end of the video, I'll go over again some of my favorite unconventional tips and give you a solid answer of whether or not you should be eating breakfast consistently. Now, the first thing we need to consider is your total daily calorie intake. And that by far is the most important thing when it comes to your nutrition plan, when it comes to being fueled. And if your goal is body composition changes, that's gonna be the biggest driver of progress. And for most hoopers, that calorie goal tends to be pretty high, upwards of 3,000, 4,000, even 5,000 plus calories a day. And if you're skipping an entire meal and maybe not eating until noon or 1 or 2 in the afternoon, that's gonna be tough to hit that daily calorie goal. So if you have a higher calorie target, it's something to consider, and it might not be the best idea to skip breakfast and do something like intermittent fasting. Now, if you have a relatively lower calorie target, if you're in a deficit, you're trying to lose body fat, or you're a smaller person and you just don't have to eat as many calories, it might not really impact you that much, and you might still be able to get your total daily calorie needs in. So again, it's very context dependent, but for most hoopers, what I see is that your calorie goals are pretty damn high because you're doing so much activity. So skipping breakfast can make it pretty difficult to hit that daily calorie target, and that is really gonna negatively impact your performance. Another thing we need to consider is your macronutrient intake, so your proteins, carbs, and your fats. And just like calories, macronutrient goals are a very big driver of your progress, maybe slightly less important than total calories, but really one of the biggest priorities when it comes to your nutrition. So if skipping breakfast takes away from your ability to hit your macro targets, probably not a good idea to skip breakfast. If you're able to hit your macros on a daily basis and still spread your protein intake out through 3 to 5 meals per day, even if you start eating at noon, if you can get 3 to 5 meals in per day, you're probably good there. So again, super context dependent, depends on your individual situation and preferences and lifestyle. But in general, it tends to make it more difficult to hit your macronutrient targets. Now, the third thing we need to consider is, does skipping breakfast negatively impact your performance? And some research has demonstrated that, decreased strength and resistance training efforts, decreased endurance, things of that nature. And that might be just because your total daily calorie needs aren't being met, but still, there's something to that. So again, if you're a basketball player looking to really maximize your performance, I probably wouldn't recommend skipping breakfast completely, just because it's gonna make it difficult to hit your calorie target, it's gonna make it difficult to hit your macro targets, and those two things combined contribute to number three, that idea that skipping breakfast may actually negatively impact your performance in the gym and on the basketball court, which is obviously not what we want. Now, before we get into my favorite tip that's gonna help you out a ton, definitely be sure to drop a like on this video if you're enjoying it so far. And as for that tip that I mentioned, it's the idea that breakfast doesn't have to be breakfast foods. There's this idea that you need to have like eggs and pancakes or eggs and cereal or eggs and oatmeal, or I'm trying to think of another protein source. I guess Greek yogurt or something like that fits into breakfast foods. But the reality is breakfast doesn't need to be breakfast foods. And that can make things a lot easier for you. Like if you're not a fan of breakfast foods, cool. Have some chicken, rice, and broccoli for breakfast. I don't really care. If that's not your thing and you like breakfast foods, have breakfast foods. I really don't care. I would just recommend getting a meal in earlier in the day because that's gonna help you hit your calorie targets, hit your macro targets, and overall improve your performance and improve muscle gain, improve fat loss, all that stuff is gonna make it easier. So in general, I would probably recommend that you get your breakfast in, and again, keep in mind, you don't have to just eat breakfast foods at breakfast. So my question of the day for you is, do you currently eat breakfast? And if so, what's your go-to meal for breakfast currently? Drop a comment down below, let me know. And if you're in a situation where maybe you train early in the morning, you're like, I don't know if I can get breakfast in, what should I do if I train that early? I actually have a video about that on the channel, so I'll put that up on the screen right now. Go check that out right now, and I will see you over there in that next video.